Dear learners, welcome to the session on e-content tools. Today, we'll be discussing about various types of e-content tools, how you can create audios, videos, and textual e-content. Also, how you can author course content using course authoring tools. E-content tools are also known as content creation tools, which enable you to create e-content, which may be used in any e-learning course or as a standalone learning module. These tools are used to produce single media content like text, image, graphics, animation, audio and a video, which are powerful teaching learning resources. As e-content to be used in e-learning and online learning, there must be interactivity ingrained in it, for which we use content authoring tools, which we'll be discussing a little later. You can use authoring tools to create final application like learning module merely by linking together various media of text, images, audio or a video and build interactivity according to the author or the teacher. You will need to be sequencing in an appropriate order and interactivity to build a package wherein e-content conveys the content and objectives are achieved as envisioned. Course authoring tools are also known as authorware. These programs will help you to create multimedia integrated e-learning modules. Thus, e-content can be created which can be used, reused and distributed without any quality loss on sharing. There is no single way of creating e-content. There are plenty of tools available and it is up to you to select the tool. These available tools can be classified as freeware, free and open source software, also called as FOSS, the proprietary softwares or the softwares in public domain on the basis of the business model they have adopted. Let us discuss one by one. As the name suggests, freeware are available to anyone without any money. The tool may be used or even distributed free of charge, but changes cannot be made as the source code of the software is not available to all. Thus, it cannot be modified and redistributed. The other is free and open source software, which is like a freeware as it is freely available. But in this case, source code is made available to anyone who is interested to know. It is like a recipe of a dish, which is available so that anyone can modify it. The developer of the software releases the source code or the recipe of the software under open license, which gives others rights to study, use, modify and redistribute. Sometimes the free and open source softwares in their present form is a collective, collaborative effort of many developers over a period of time. Proprietary software, which is a group of software that is possessed and maintained by any individual or a company. As in many businesses, the source code is confidential and is the property of the company or the individual, as the case may be. It is available for a price and one has to buy a license to use it. It cannot be copied or distributed without complying with the licensing agreements of the software. Here is it another category like public domain software, where the developer or the copyright holder releases it in public domain. It can be used by anyone for any purpose. Now let us discuss about e-content creation tools. We'll start by discussing text-based e-content. Any text-based tool may be used for creation of this content, like LibreOffice, OpenOffice. They are the FOSS version of Office tools and work well in creating text-based e-content. Microsoft Office is proprietary software which can be used for creating text-based e-content. Both of these are used for job work. Apache OpenOffice is an open source office productivity software whose main components are for word processing, spreadsheets, presentations, graphics and databases. A text e-content can also be developed through collaboration using web-based tools like Etherpad, Wiki. Etherpad is an online collaborative editor which supports real-time editing. It allows authors to work simultaneously in collaborative manner to edit a text document. All the authors can see each other's edit, and that too in real time. Same is the Wiki functionality, which is the basis of Wikipedia, the largest developed online encyclopedia developed by people like you and me. We all visit it sometimes for quenching our thirst of knowledge. If we want to make an e-book, Calibre has become a comprehensive tool for the management of digital text. It is a free and open source cross-platform e-book manager. You can make it to edit, convert, view and catalog e-books in all major e-book formats, fetch metadata for your books, download newspapers and convert it into e-books. Another important genre of e-content is image or graphics based e-content. Images say more than 1,000 words. It is a very important component of any e-content and e-learning course. Let us discuss few e-content tools for creating images or graphics. Inkscape is a cross-platform vector graphics software of professional quality to create variety of graphics such as illustrations, icons, logos, diagrams, maps, and web graphics. It has sophisticated drawing tools with capabilities comparable to proprietary software like Adobe Illustrator, CorelDRAW. It can import and export various file formats including SVG, AI, PDF, PS, PNG and has a simple interface and multilingual support. It can be downloaded from this URL. GIMP is an acronym of GNU Image Manipulation Program for tasks as photo retouching, image composition and image authoring. As it is a powerful image editor and has functionality of Photoshop, it acts as a good first alternative to Adobe Photoshop. It has features like powerful painting tools, layers, channel support, editable text layers and so on. Another set of image creation tools are concept mapping tools. Concept maps are used to graphically represent the relationship between various concepts, their sub-concepts, to get a clear and deep understanding of holistic perspective. In teaching and learning, you can easily create concept map on various topics, edit it, link it to the websites, and add graphics in digital mode. Once made, these maps may be used by others as well and add to the resource repository related to the subject in your institution. There are many digital concept mapping tools which help in creation of e-content in visual form. Some of the similar tools are mind map tools. Few famous open source concept mapping tools are Visual Understanding Environment, short called as VUE, FreeMind and FreePlane. CMap is also a good free tool for concept mapping. The Visual Understanding Environment is a concept and content mapping application developed to support teaching, learning and research. It has basic simple interface consisting of notes and links which are used for depicting relationships between concepts, ideas and digital content. It has the features such as dynamic presentation of maps, map merging, enhanced keyword tagging, search capabilities are there. So that is why it is one of the popular concept mapping tools available. Another easy and popular concept mapping tool is CMap, which is a freeware. It empowers users to construct, navigate, share and criticize knowledge models represented as concept maps. Another category of e-content creation tools is animation-based. According to Wikipedia, animation is a method in which pictures are manipulated to appear as moving images. In traditional animation, images are drawn or painted by hand on transparent celluloid sheets to be photographed and exhibited on a film. Today, most animations are made with computer-generated imagery. Blender is one of the effective and cross-platform free and open source 3D animation creation software. It supports the entirety of 3D pipeline, modeling, rigging, animation, simulation, rendering, compositing, and motion tracking, even video editing and game creation. Blender is well suited to individuals and small studios who benefit from its unified pipeline and responsive development process. It can be downloaded from the URL given on the screen. Audio e-content. Creation and editing tools are also important. Audacity is a cross-platform, easy and free and open source software for audio recording and editing. It is a multi-track audio recorder as well as editor. It enables us to record live audio as well as computer playback. It enables to import sound files, edit them and combine them with other files or do new recordings. It is quite a popular audio editing tool. WavePad is a free and powerful audio editing tool like Audacity. It has got all the full features of a professional audio and music editor. It lets you record and edit music, voice, and other audio recordings. When editing audio files, you can cut, copy, and paste parts of recordings and then add effects like echo, amplifications, and it also supports a number of other file formats. Another important category of e-content tool is video e-content creation and editing. Video e-content tool can be simple camera, used to record the live process, event, or for telling a story. Also, screencasting tools are used wherein the screen of the computer is captured to teach something happening on the computer screen, especially the software functioning. Let us start with screencasting software. CamStudio is a free and open source desktop recorder streaming video software. It allows you to record all screen and audio activity on your computer and create industry standard AVI video file. You can use its inbuilt SWF producer to turn these AVIs into lean, mean, bandwidth friendly streaming flash videos. Open Broadcaster software is a free and open source cross-platform software for screencasting, video editing, video recording, and live streaming. It is a high-performance, real-time video audio capturing and mixing software. It enables you to create scenes made up of multiple sources, including window captures, images, text, browser windows, webcams, capture cards, and more. OpenShot is another software which is free, simple to use, open source video editor for cross-platform operating systems. It is a user-friendly software which everyone can use and get great results. It is easy to cut, slice, and edit any video using OpenShot. Also, one can easily add subtitles and transitions in it. Audio mixing and editing is possible in OpenShot. It can export films to DVD, YouTube, Vimeo, and many other platforms. VVideo is an online video editor that makes it easy to capture, create, view, and share your movies at up to 4K resolutions for stunning playback anywhere. It has advanced video editing features made easy through a simple interface. It allows you to control the video sections easily in areas like transition, fast and slow motion, add effects. It has free as well as paid versions. Now let us talk about the content authoring tools. Till now we discussed many tools to create e-content. These tools focused on one media and specialized in creation of that media. But these tools are not built to develop interactivity, testing and scoring. Interactive Multimedia, or the IMM, is developed when we integrate various elements such as image, animation, video and interactivity in one package. There are special tools available for creating interactive multimedia. The content authoring tools are software packages which can be used to create interactive multimedia content and run it through a browser as web content for the use of other people. It is also very useful for the learning management systems. Authoring tools allow you or the e-content developer to integrate or use any array of media to create professional, engaging and interactive e-content. Wikipedia defines an authoring tool as a software application used to create multimedia content, typically for delivery on the World Wide Web or the Internet. Content authoring tools may also create content in other file formats so that material can be provided through compact disc or the CD or in other formats for various users. Authoring tools can be used by people with minimum technical skills. The main advantage of authoring tools is their easier and faster use. Using these tools, e-content can be developed and transferred very easily. The authoring tools can be proprietary, free, as well as open source. Today we'll discuss some free and open source ones. Let's start with the EXE Learning. EXE Learning is a free and open source software tool that can be used to create educational interactive web content. It provides an authoring environment which is based on XHTML. Thus the name is arrived as an acronym to e-learning XHTML editor EXE. EXE has been developed as an offline authoring tool and thus does not require internet for design and development. EXE's WYSI, WYG, that is, what you see is what you get. This functionality enables you to see what the content will look like in its published or the final form. EXE Learn can generate interactive content with interactive activities, image galleries, or multimedia clips. It allows various digital formats that can be used independently or can be integrated into learning management systems like Moodle. It will help you to design, develop and publish web-based learning and teaching materials without the need to become proficient in HTML or complicated web publishing application. Zerti is another free and open source authoring tool with fully featured e-learning development environment for creating rich interactivity. Zerti Online Toolkits is a server-based package of tools for content authors. E-learning materials can be authored quickly and easily using browser-based tools with no programming required. Another authoring tool is H5P, which allows you to easily and quickly create rich interactive content on a web page. It has been designed to let everyone create, share and reuse interactive content. According to Wikipedia, H5P is a free and open source content collaboration framework based on JavaScript. It is an abbreviation of HTML5 package and aims to make it easy for everyone to create, share and reuse interactive HTML5 content. Interactive videos, interactive presentations, quizzes, interactive timelines and more have been developed and shared using H5P. Another e-content generation is through films. Videos like the one you are watching, YouTube is full of such videos. We often use it. Pedagogy related videos are available at TeacherTube and can be used freely for teaching learning purpose. You can use the videos on TeacherTube as well as contribute there. So today we have discussed that there is no single way of creating e-content. There are plenty of tools available and it is up to the author or teacher like you to select the tools. E-content is the backbone of e-learning and online learning. The e-content tools could be for creation of text-based e-content like LibreOffice, OpenOffice, Etherpad, Wiki. Images and graphics, say more than 1,000 words, so we can use Inkscape, GIMP for creating graphics and images. Audio e-content creation and editing softwares are Audacity and WavePad. Video e-content creation and editing is also very important. Screencasting can be done through CamStudio and Open Broadcaster software, OpenShot, VVideo. They are the easily available online video editors. Some of the popular content authoring tools are EXE, Xerti, H5P. Happy e-content creation. Thank you.